Good morning, everyone. I am here getting ready to upgrade my Honda CRF 450 RL, and it's a little bit of a rainy day outside today, so I think I'm going to do it in the shed. But I came outside this morning to go start bringing my parts out so I can start working on it, and just happened to come outside and notice that my 250L laid over. It has this problem of falling over on its own. Whenever I'm outside and it rains, for whatever reason, the kickstand sinks down in the mud and bike falls over. So yes, my 250's actually got the FMX exhaust, the Racetech front suspension, the EKG fuel management system. It's got a few upgrades on it. So anyways, let's walk over here and see what we're gonna be putting on my 450 RL. Alrighty, so I've got the bike here and it's stock right now. No changes have been made to it. It's got about 500 miles on it. So I came over here and got a few parts. I got the IMS fuel tank, the 3 gallon tank. I've got a new Kenda back tire, the 270. I've got a rim locker, an extra tube, the AIM fuel management system, and 30 millimeter handlebar risers. Oh, and let's not forget the seat concept seat that I'm gonna be putting on here. So I'm gonna go through, start tearing the bike down while it's actually still in the garage. So we'll see what kind of performance upgrades we're gonna get. And I'll get back with you later. Alright, so I have got my 450 RL. I got it out. Haven't started it yet. Picked up my 250 and moved it over to a little bit more solid ground. So, it survived the fall. Normally this one does too. So, the 450 RL with factory, just come out factory, no modifications to it at all. Go ahead and start it. And I found you have to let it run for 10-15 seconds before you try and give it any throttle, or else it'll die. It's like cold nature whenever you start it. So anyways, I want to get it out. The streets are a little bit wet. See what I mean? Get it out, take it for a quick drive, let you see what a factory 450 RL is, then after the modifications. My Yoshimura exhaust system is still a couple days away, so I'll get all the other mods that I have to tear everything off the gas tank, the seat and all done today, and then we'll go from there. Say hi to Spock.
Hi Spock.
Thank you. replace this driveway one of these days. So let's go ahead and get in here, start getting the bike tore apart, and get everything upgraded. Then we'll take it for another ride. Of course, this is probably a bad move because now the engine's hot and I've got to tear everything off of it. So I will be back with you later. So I've got my 450 RL put back together, the seat concept seat, the IMS fuel tank, and the AEM ECU. So, and I've got the AEM handlebar switch. So since I've got it put back together, I haven't even tried to start it yet. So let's see what happens since I've emptied the gas tank and moved a new one on here. So So I'm in neutral. So I kind of figured that. So I've got map control. I need to go to map 4 or 5 because I'm still running the exhaust. ECU on here, and this is its maiden run, so we'll see if there's any power difference. A lot better for throttle response. Do the easy stuff, make sure it's gonna ride. Low RPMs are doing good. I don't want to eat up my yard. And 30 seconds into the ride, I crashed. All right, let's do this again. I can get it flipped around. Wet grass banks don't work too well. As I said, I didn't make a video unless I crashed within 30 seconds. All right, take number 2. Let's roll down here to lower ground and try this. Starts up a lot easier. Thank you. So let's go ahead and fill this thing up. No pins for you. I always use 93 octane. Nearly 2 gallons. So I had a gallon of gas in there, which was about right. Now let's go get a drink.
Lord,
see ya. Alrighty. So much easier. Come on.